God, it says in multiple places that God grants repentance, and he also grants faith. That we are walking through life as the walking dead. We're spiritually dead before him. We do not desire him. We do not walk after his glory. We are chained to our sin. Jesus said, whoever sins is a slave to sin. A slave to sin. My friends, you need a new master. Jesus Christ is that master. When you repent and submit yourself and give allegiance to the rightful King, King Jesus, then, my friends, he fills you with new life. He forgives your sins and grants you the inheritance of the saints. Eternal life in the new heavens and new earth with God forever and ever. And heaven, a world of love. And my friends, the only way for you to receive love into your heart by the Holy Spirit is to listen to the call. That call to repent of sin, you obey that call. And say, yes, God, have mercy on me. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your attributes, according to your steadfast love, according to your abundant mercy. Oh, blot out my transgressions. Jesus told the woman at Jacob's well, you do not have the living water because you haven't asked. You need to ask. If you would just simply ask for the living water, the Messiah would give you that living water. Oh, the gift of God. You don't work for the gift of God. The gift of salvation, you don't work for it. All right? You simply stretch out your empty hand, a desperate, empty hand of faith. Of faith. Of faith. See, faith looks to the merits of another. Faith looks outside of yourself. Faith is no action of yourself. Faith looks outside of you to the merit, the righteousness of someone else. And that righteousness is Jesus. See, he was born of a virgin, not stained by the sin of Adam like you and me. See, this Messiah would not be stained by evil. He is the pure.